We put the zap back into computers. Sinclair's action pack with light gun.
If you have about £3,500 to spend on a micro, how about this? Yes, a 9-carat gold QL available from the London jewellers Asprey. But has the QL been a gold mine for Sir Clive Sinclair? And indeed, does the final production version of the QL exist yet? I'll be putting these and other questions to him later in the show. Sequence was written by Paul Rhodes on a Spectrum. Well done. As this is the last programme in the present series, and we have received so much good software from you, we have just closed our eyes and selected this last title sequence. Sadly, though, we have not received a single programme from any ladies.
Which I find totally amazing. However, if you own a BBC Micro and you've built the light software circuit, then this is your week, and we really do believe we've got it right this time. Place the circuit in position when the black dot appears, and stand by then to press the space bar to download the software when the instruction tells you so to do.
Well, from the Spectrum to the QL, and welcome, Sir Clive.
Thank you.
Now, last week, David Carlin was here and was telling us that most of the initial problems with the QL had been overcome. Has it, in fact, been relaunched?
It's been relaunched, yes, in the sense that we've now got all the software, we've overcome all the problems, I may say, not just some of them, but all the initial problems, and so we've relaunched in the sense that we've shown to all our dealers and to all the software houses all everything that's available for it. We now have a very wide range of software and, of course, a wide range of peripherals from other manufacturers.
Now, the QL didn't really address the mass market that you were hoping for in its sort of first launch. Is it mainly the software that you think is going to make it do that this time round?
Well, I don't think it was just the lack of software last year that made the results less than we expected. It was the early teething troubles and the fact that we just couldn't make the machines in the early part of last year. But now we've sold all that, but even allowing for that, we sold over 50,000 machines last year, which is more than any other serious machine. Clearly, it's much less than the machine that sells principally on games, but that's not the category the QL is in. So we're very confident that it'll be, continue to be, the very best-selling serious machine.
Now, some of those 50,000, you know, existing QL users have been writing to us. One problem they have at the moment is that you've now said that the QL club membership is now free. Mm-hmm. And they've asked us to put the question to you, can they get their £35 money back?
Well, we hope that they found the club valuable and they paid for it, so no, they can't. I mean, we did, that was a deal we did then, and we've got a new deal now.
So no money back for the existing users?
No.
Now, the QL does use a sort of a non-standard operating system. It also uses the micro drives that we were talking about last year.
Non-standard. It's our standard.
Yes.
And you could say that the Spectrum is non-standard, but because it's the most popular machine by far, then it is a standard in its own right.
Okay, but it's not compatible with a number of other machines that are available on the market. The question was really,
machines really are compatible with each other.
Right, but the question was really is, do you think that has addressed a problem that the software houses have had in terms of getting the software ready?
No, not at all. The software houses have had a problem with our machine and with, say, the Apple Macintosh, because the 68,000 chip was a lot to bite off. It's a very much more powerful chip than the Z80 that we've used previously, or the 6502 that Apple have used previously. It's a very powerful chip indeed, and it's taken the software. One thing is, and the other side of the coin is, that having achieved that, having come to terms with it, they're producing some very dramatic software indeed.
Now, of course, it mustn't be forgotten that this software runs on the Sinclair QL, a machine which at last today picked up one of the major awards. I put it earlier to Sir Clive Sinclair. He must be pleased about the award. But what happens next?
Well, the next thing that we see, really, is portables next year. The portable computer, I believe, is the way of the future. If you can offer portability without any compromise, we think we'll do that. That's what people really need.
Now, you say without any compromise. Does that mean it will use micro drives or what?
It'll use micro drives, as does the QL, of course, as does the one per desk from ICL, and, you know, the micro drivers now. It's perhaps the most used medium there is, if one thinks about it, a number of machines that are in production. So it certainly is microdrive, because that, you know, as I say, is the best answer to that particular problem. But when we say without compromise, we mean without compromise on cost, on the display. The displays are a major problem with portables at present, because they have to use liquid crystals to get the displays, to get power consumption down, and they simply don't give a very good result. We've got our own solution to that, our flat tube technology, which gives a CRT type of display, like a benchtop unit, but without the power consumption that would normally take in a flat package. So that's unique. And it's got to have the performance of a proper computer. So we're putting it all in a portable package. So it's as I say, it's not a compromise. It's a machine you would choose to use on a desk, but it's portable as well.
All right. Well, just let me press you once more on microdrives. The microdrive, is it going to be Spectrum compatible or QL compatible? Because that's fairly important to a lot of people.
Right. This one will be Spectrum compatible.
Right. Okay. When are we going to see it?
That'll be next year. Certainly in the first half of next year. Not an exact date set yet.
Now, I know it seems as if I've been pressing you to tell me the exact date. Is there a danger, do you think, that you might be releasing it too soon, that it might be on the market before it's quite ready?
No. We do learn our lessons. It certainly won't be on the market before it's ready.